Hello. Good morning. So, what we're going to do right now is make a quick thumbnail for Era. In order to do that, we just need to make some mask modifiers, and then we're going to move it over to the other scene. I will do this. It would be easiest to go on here. Hey, follow Olasco 22. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Hello. Good morning. Hope you have a good start to your Thursday. Mostly work on VR chat avatars. It's kind of a work stream more than a stream. Don't know how to put that, but yeah, if you have any questions at all, feel free to let me know. So what we're gonna do here, I'm gonna create some masks. So this will be the royal clothing. To mask this, this will be to turn off the royal clothing. Yeah. So Alt A, deselect everything, go to our this here, select that stuff, and assign it to our group here. Then I find our mask there. And now it always inverts it for some reason, which I don't like. Like, I want to hide this stuff, should mask this stuff. Anyway, so now we got one for the royal clothing. Let's add another. This will be, we'll actually label this royal. This will be mask casual. We'll do the same thing. Make another mask. Group. Casual. A tab into here, make sure everything's deselected with Alt A. Me, indeed, yes, we're gonna be also good morning, Eric. We're making your thumbnail. Since I was able to, we have a little bit of work to do on pics today, but it'll be super, super minimal. And then I want to get your thumbnail done, and then we'll switch over to the other stuff. Hey there, pics, welcome, welcome. Hope you're both having a fantastic morning. Yeah, for the picks for the body, I mean, that's just one shader. So I'll be sending you an updated shader, and that's pretty much it. So it should be a very small tweak. Because I know which one's wrong. Right, but now with these masks, we can toggle stuff. Turn on the royal clothing, and we can turn on the casual clothing. And we just need one for the body as well, just so there's no major clipping. Actually, go ahead and do that. I basically just want to grab. Let's do a one of these. Morning meeting. Never ends. Never ends for Era. Or poor guy. All right, before we do that, let's go ahead and select the wings and hide them. Just the wings, please. Interesting. I'm making this too complicated. Just grab the stuff. Basically, this here. Shift L, shift L, shift L. Clothing, deselect, hair, deselect. Doesn't need to be perfect, but does need to work nicely. Do there. Right. Tail, we don't want selected. Here, right about there. All right, so this will be the mask body casual sign. Weird name, I know. The idea is that when we apply this or duplicate this. Now we can turn off the clothing. Oh, we do want that off. Put this on. And we need to swap this to our new mask. There we go. Right. Some sort of threshold thing that. I don't quite understand, but looks like it's just a little bit too big. Let's go in here, deselect, grab that group, invert the selection and grow it one and say remove. That should give us perfect results. Yes. Okay. So now we've got the ready for the casual set up. Next, what we'd like to do is one more mask. For the royal body, the royal cloak.
The royal cloak.
He looks like some character like jazz music. He's kind of a, oh, like a beatnik. Yeah, I get that. Good morning, Dad. Welcome to the street. How's your day going? Raining. Oh, raining again. Wow. I'm jealous. I want the rain. Was Joe staying with you? I think he was. Select that. Yes. Jill leaves tomorrow. Gotcha. Okay. Perfect. So I got another day without him. Perfect. Good news for me. Actually, let's just a little bit simpler. But we need some of them. Well, I hope you're having a good time. Make sure to beat them up for me. Important. Important stuff. Beating up your brother. Right, there we go. So we'll make a new group. Mask body royal. I'll sign that there. And now we can make one more. Always forget. So these need to be off. This one on. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so no clipping on the body. It's a little bit of clipping right there. There should be no clipping. Not allowed. Him dinner, take him out to the gym, otherwise he's doing that work thing. Work. Who does that? Who does that? Only fools, let me tell you. I just didn't assign it yet. I need to remember to do that. And we will include this group. Very confused. Me who worked today. Yeah, who does that? Why is it grabbing the whole loop? Oh, interesting. Gotcha. Because of the mask. New blender behavior detected. All right, that should do it. paint. I'm so confused. Didn't I assign all this stuff? Did I assign it to the wrong group? Man, I feel like I'm taking crazy pills. Depends on the jazz style. He prefers angry music, such as punk or like, but jazz can be good if it has some good emotion. How about punk jazz? Needs to be this threshold thing. There we go. Something like that. All right, I think we're good now. Now we can swap between the two outfits. Nice. All right, we're gonna take a quick break from this. We'll swap over to Pix, get that wrapped up, and then move back to Era. I need to bring in the materials now for Era. Speaking of materials, let's get the body taken care of. So you can see that it's clipping right here. And that's because we need to take the body material here from the first character. And we need to make a version just for Pix 2. And we just unlock it. Shouldn't be pink or magenta or whatever. Should still have all the same alignments, which it does, so it's upset about something else. That's okay. What we want to do is lock in this here. You know, confirm that merge, so get version here. Perfect. I think that's it. It's usually the only thing it makes. Okay, and then we can lock it in. Wait. Unlock it again. That's the same spelling, right? Pix body. V2 body delete. This one. Oh, it's when I copied it. Interesting. I should probably just re-bring that in. That's okay. Later. Now, we have this one. And the main difference is that we need to tell it to look at UV 0. We can lock it in. It's really the only difference. All right. Then we can go to the FBX file, tell it to look at our new version of material. Apply. And in this new version, should be able to hide portions of the body. Okay. Select the body. Yep, this is UV1 body. Okay. It should be working. Fix body. Ah, wait, so this is the older version. XV1, gotcha. Confusing. XV2 gets spotty. Phew. Bam. All right. Yes. There we go. All right, lock it in again. I need to bring in the original Pix package to refresh version 1. Make sure that there's no weird change there. All right. Okay, so now should be disabling. To test, we're gonna take the PixV2 animator, drop it in, save, play. And shouldn't be any clipping. Nope, no clipping, and no clipping. And when we hit jacket, just that one value, body. Sod, I swear that was. Oh, of course it was working fine because before I wasn't disabling the body as well. Gotcha. So that's why it tricked me. It tricked me. Body. When the jacket is on, we have that set correctly, but we want the body to do this, I believe. Yes, we can see the little piece of flesh poking out. We copy this, go to jacket off, paste it, and swap it. Now we can hit play. Lot of boom. Okay, much better. And the gun's not doing anything weird. I don't know why it was to start with, but now it's not. All right, perfect. So remove the animator, save. Save. I don't think there's any changes to my. We'll just double check. Okay, so everything should be good to go in that regard. Yeah, as long as the body has the legs off to start with. Okay, perfect. Next, though, we want to return to Pix version 1. Make sure to refresh. One thing I should mention with the gun, side not for sake of time, shoots very easily, also activates his emote. Yeah, the emotes, I was torn on that because you'll want to be able to make gestures when you have your gun out, I would assume. That I want. The refresh of this. Does it need to update the original scene? I don't think so. He just looks shocked every time he shoots, though. To be honest, it's kind of funny. I can move the if you want the expression to be on a different gesture. But all the gestures are there's trigger and fist. So those are the two. Or point. It would be point because you move your finger out. I'm going to set them to 5. And so those will be rock and roll gestures now. Rock and roll. That should be a little bit better. As for You appreciate that. Also, there's a way to tap so the gun doesn't shoot a mere touch of the trigger because I don't even have to squeeze it for it to shoot, just sort of blasts. I think it might be a little bit finicky when you first pick it up. Clearly, I did more testing. And as for it firing easily, there's really not much to do about that because it's like that's just VR chat making it easy to make the gesture. Like the moment you make a fist gesture, or sorry, a pointed gesture, so you lift off your index finger when you're holding the gun, like that's just going to trigger the gesture, which then triggers the shot. There's not really a way around that. There's no other way to get input from VR chat besides the gestures. If we had access to the in button presses themselves, that would be a little different, but at the very least, that should be a little bit easier for the gun. For it to fire. Gotcha. For some reason, it's just 50-50 fire when I pick it up or took it off my hip. No, I think the firing when you first pick it up is a problem. It's the firing, but just when you're holding it normally should just be gesture. So the other direction, right? Only when it's held does it go there. And when it's not held, it'll go back. Equals zero. So we want this to not equal zero. When it doesn't, when it's not zero, or no, that's not quite right. Zero, no, it equals zero when it's greater than zero. There we go. Then it should go there. When it's equal to zero, it should go back to the idle stage because that way it'll go into the held on that initial grab. And then it'll only go into held and shooting, or it'll only shoot. It gets there. So if we just add a little bit of exit time, same as the exit time on this one, 0.1, exit time of 0.1, or no, it's actually 1. That should do it. Other two things, gesture gunfire, pick it up, close body, click through the close, works like a charm. Gotcha. Yeah, so those should be fixed. Can I tell you how much of a little excited giggle I did when I got to see my own mantis blades? It is very fun. It is very, very fun to get the mantis blades. If you ever get tracking on your elbow, you'll be able to do like full swings a little bit easier. VR chat doesn't track your elbow, unfortunately. Or headsets don't track your elbow. All right, we'll do a quick upload. To my account. Perfect. Okay. Then we'll go to picks. Vdo. Bam, bam, bam. Override pipeline manager. Detach that for right now. Picks v2, copy, paste, attach. Upload to my account. That was picks v2. And we remove the animator. Okay, perfect. Build and publish, and then we'll test once, move on. Hey, Jordan, thank you for the sub to a subscription of 2 months. Thank you. Thank you. I hope you're doing well. Oh, I'm back, by the way. I sent you a DM. Let's check.
Perfect.
Are you drawing dicks again? All the time, my friend. All the time. Oh, Era. That's too kind. Thank you. Thank you. Big is good. Indeed. All right, sorry, I just had to be getting my communication done. Okay, so we uploaded. That's my endeavor. That's my challenge. Be good at communication. ADD challenge number one. He's pulling on my hair. Right. Of course. I always forget. Also, everyone, I went to the life drawing world in VR chat, and that was super fun. I think I'll be trying to get some groups together to go into there regularly because it was a blast, honestly. And I have some thoughts on like doing some content and stuff, like finding people, finding like really interesting avatars, going in there and drawing them. Went there with my friend the other day. It was so much fun. It is. I need to learn how to properly draw there. Oh no, it is a challenge. It's like it's very floaty. Your hands like floating off the canvas and stuff. Did I even open for desktop? I don't think I did. But it's very cool. But yeah, I think I might do some like life drawing classes at some point for people. Teach life drawing and stuff. That'd be super fun. I love life drawing. And it's cool too, because apparently that set. Sam, may I request you upload this for me again? My Unity's honestly being a bitch. Absolutely. No, I don't mind uploading. Just gonna test the gun, and then we'll get to it. But yeah, apparently that the canvases and the drawing and the pens and stuff, that you can bring into your own worlds. You can purchase the assets. So I think I'll do like custom life drawing setups, which would be super fun. Ones with a bit more lighting variation. Let's go check it All right, so. Still a little too easy to. Still fires on the first grab. Okay, I know how to fix it. I know how to fix it. I've got the technology. Can't wait for lighter headsets. Yay! Yeah, that's the character I finished recently, Jordan. This is the second version of Pix. It's got cyberpunk stuff. He even has a little mantis blade that pops out of his arm. Ching! Very fun stuff. Okay, so what we're gonna do for to fix the gun is we know what's gonna happen, right? We know that the gun is going to go from the idle to here when it's held. What we can do is create an intermediate step. Me just copy the idle actually right here. So what will happen is we'll go here. When it's being held, so when it's greater than zero, when we pick up the gun, goes into this idle state. But we can only go here once gesture. Oh shit, don't know which one. It is. So we'll have two. We'll have two of them. Okay. Make transition here. Or no. Didn't want a second transition. I just want gun left equals one. So just as when we're entering the shooting state, we'll say left hand buffer. Buffer left. So we pick up the gun and it's in the left hand and it equals one, but only when gesture left does not equal one will it go here. Perfect. Big brain. We'll do gesture or buffer right. So this one will go here when gesture right equals one. And the gun is held. But it'll only leave this state when gesture right does not equal one. So when you let go of the trigger. This should work. Should work. Save, VR chat, build and publish. Boom, boom. Upload it again. Sending messages. Taskmaster. That's me. I'm a taskmaster. A master taxer. Okay. Please don't shoot. Pick it up. All right, perfect. It's working. Shit, I always forget. I think if I always forgot something that I would remember if that I forget. But then I forget that I forget every time. All right. Just want to rename this to buffer. Right. Okay, perfect. So now there's no hair trigger option. And we'll go ahead and export this package. No need to include dependencies. Picks, if you're there. When I do these changes, when I send another Unity package, so unless it's like a new commission, you will want to install them in order. So the first Unity package, then the second Unity package. I did do the no dependencies, right? Maybe. Drive. This is taking a while. Okay, y'all.
Just give me a day when we could talk, voice chat, like 5 to 10 minutes, and I could screen share my stuff and show you what I have in mind. I really have to watch out that I don't build an accident. Okay, so what I was saying is, yes, it would be definitely in progress, but you will just make certain finishing touches and adding more blend shapes, bone shapes. But you don't have to do that. I mean, I already found a guy who's willing to do that to his extent, a guy called Blank. So far, he has been doing a great job.
This is it's just someone reaching out to me regarding some changes to an avatar.
You would pick up upon, but I could show you the avatar.
One time, Cade Art responded to a YouTube comment I made, and I was very proud of that. Very proud. Reminds me, I promised you an ad. I should script that out. Oh, for that'd be cool. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I think that the sticky bones, squishy bones, just came out today. I'm interested to see if that helps your tail. So I might take a look at that after we finish up picks here, which should take just one more second. Apparently, it takes a long time to upload this stuff. It'd be pretty simple because all the tail needs is just the ability to kind of pull apart just a little bit. It It's just because everything is rigidly attached, I believe. I don't know why it takes so long to compress. Anyway, I'll be right back. I just have to run to the restroom. Return. All right. There we go. Now the tweaks are uploaded. I can log out of this. We can log into Pix. Hopefully it doesn't ask for another code. Pixel, you were just sent a verification code. If you could send that to me, I'm going to Discord you too. Perfect. Thank you. Yeah, James Bond would be proud. All right. So first thing to do is we want to actually just revert this change. We'll go back to that one. This, there shouldn't be anything different here. We'll leave it. That means I need to export the Unity package one more time because the avatar thing is a little different. Is it bad that I've been overly excited for the thumbnail portion of the No, absolutely. I've been looking forward to it for a while. I think that's going to be really fun. Da-da-da-da, content manager. Okay, so should be good. Just build and publish to PixV2. go. And then one more time, the Unity package, upload. I'm gonna make a new folder here. All right. Uploaded to your account, the recent changes, character should be good to go. Now let's go ahead. Sam Dune. Yeah. All right, one more time, let's export this Unity package. I don't know why it's taking so long to compress the files. Usually it's not that long. Heck yeah! I could, for the ad, find my bloody cables and do some flights and do on a base. Oh, that'd be cool. Just octaves for the bass line. I don't know what an octave means. You know what a C note is? Yes. I think so. If only I could see it. Oh. It's 8 notes higher in tone, to put it simply. Interest. Okay. Got it. So an octave is just any note, and an octave is a note relative to the, it's an increment that you move. Octave, but yes, oh, interesting. Okay, perfect. So we've got the file done. We've got the, that's the wrong person. There we go. Okay, so files have been uploaded, pics, and that's good to go. Okay, so what we want to do now is take the textures, ignore that one. We're going to copy this. Can I copy paste it like that? Need a textures folder. Perfect. Paste these here. All right, that's uploading. Let's hop into this scene. Just one moment. Okay. So want to do is look at the tail. First, we actually want to update to the latest version. Please don't break. Last time we got hung up about the blueprint creation. All right, files sent to Pix. Everything's uploaded. We got the latest update here, but we do have the same error. Let's just close Unity and reopen it. Hello, Zoom. Welcome. Salutations to you as well. All right. Perfect. Whew. So much juggling. All right, so it still is missing some sort of fizzbone thing. The typer namespace fizzbone grab helper could not be found. This needs to be updated. How are you doing, Zoom? Is ZP working well? Seems to have worked. Now we can go to the Fizzbone's tail and version 1.1. You change the way your component works. Some values may look differently and need to be manually changed, blah, 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 blah. Continue. All right. Stretch motion. The amount motion will affect the squash stretch of the bones. Value 0 means the bones will only squash stretch as a result of grabbing or collisions. Maximum amount the bones can shrink. So let's just say, oops. What the? One and point one. And play. It does look better. It's interesting. It feels like it's got a lot more inertia. But I think that's where we left it off last time. If I do turn down the stiffness, what do we get? Certainly feels like it isn't freaking out as much as it was in the past. So last time I would do this a bunch, eventually it would snap. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it does look really good. Yeah, I think that's working way better. All right. I think we can even turn down the immobile a little bit. Let's see. Main thing is rotation. Okay, that's where the snapping is coming. Rotation. Let's turn up that immobile again. Everything moves with the rotation. It is improved. Let's turn up the stretch. Wait, 5. But it is still. Let me turn down the stiffness again. Mobile. Stiffness all the way off. Momentum. It's certainly not freaking out like it was in the past. There's still a little bit of jitter, but it's not like suddenly in a different position. Little but dramatic improvement. Exactly. That's fun. Let's see. Let's just turn on the squash, or actually, I'm going to turn up both of these maximum. Just see what that looks like. Hard to tell too much of a difference, but it does seem to be much more reactive and it's not glitching. Still shaky, but no glitch. Super flowy. Yeah, what did you think of this? Does this look good? Too flowy? Looks good to me. The tail is prehensile, so okay, perfect. And I wonder what happens if I just turn the pull off. Funny. it just floats in the air. So that's not what we want. We don't want the floating. Looks better than any bigtails I've ever seen so far. Oh, good. And I like the pull. I like a little bit of pull. 3.1, I think, is what we had it at. Yeah. And the stretch and squash and stretch, they're not doing much here. Let's just double check that in the documentation. The amount of motion will affect the squat, stretch, squash. So value of 0 means bones will stretch only as a result of grabbing. This value is a multiple of the original bone length. Okay. So I would assume by 1, it's actually, it can stretch to twice its length. So technically, you could stretch the whole tail twice as far. Oh, wait, no. But it's based off this. So it's only 1.2. This, if I stretch to 2, let's see what that does. It's definitely, I think it's stretching a little bit. I think while it's moving, it's a bit longer than it actually would be. That's fun. All right. I can only play around with this for so long. I think that's good. We'll do a little bit smaller than that, just 1. Momentum. I'm going to try just turning that up really quick. Copy and paste. Oh, that's too strong. Momentum should be backed up. Stiffness. Maybe just a teensy tiny amount. That's about it. I think we're good. Right click, copy component, paste component values, save, apply all. Okay. Is this my? Second. Oh, now I have to do a code verification every time I want to log into my VR chat. Okay, so this is for my login. So we're going to detach that. All right. Now all we have to do is there's only two files we're going to send in this update. Is should just be the scene and we'll just send this whole folder. Ba, 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 ba. We'll say V two underscore a tail update. Take that back. I'm only going to send the updated prefab. That will be even simpler. If I only send this one, this file. That will guarantee the least amount of conflicts, a potential for conflicts. All right. Okay. Sent the tail fix to you. But I'll probably delete it and overwrite it because I am still making the thumbnail. Okay, now that we've done that, what we'd like to do is go into each of these materials and set up the correct thingamajig. So basically, we have all textures right here. Take this, convert color into the reference. Beautiful. Next, the body. Take all this, delete. Mission, not on the base. Rename this to smoothness. Neat. We'll have actual time today. Yay! Convert color into smooth. Or no, roughness. Noise. Then let's do these two. for the normal clothing. I guess we'll do the eyes first. This one, don't need the fanciness. The glow, we're not going to set up in Blender. Bam. All right, looking good. Next, the clothes. This should be the last one before we go in on the details. Boom. Smooth this. Color. Hey there, Arctic. Hello. How are you doing? Oh, but we do need some transparency. Take alpha there. Never works. Oh, that's the ambient occlusion. Not that. The base color. So then. Why does it look weird though? That's like from the transmission. Always better to do a mix shader. This way it just works. Just works. We just need to bring the knees back and we're good to go. Not bad, just mulling over what I want to do at the moment. Fair. The greatest curse. What should I do with some free time? Boom, so we're going to add the skull and bones. Which I believe is on the second UV map. Ooh, very cool. I mixed it with the alpha. Wanted to mix it with the color. There we go. Should go this one way or the other way. And the alpha goes in there. It's the base color from our skull and bones. Mix. It's a mix. Let's invert the alpha. It's the same thing as before. Why would it be like that? My logo being a pain. It's always interesting to jump from one shader system to another. Well, Arctic, if you haven't been yet, I went to the Life Drawing World in VR chat. It was super fun. I definitely recommend checking it out if you haven't yet. Just fun to get to hang out with a bunch of people doing a bunch of art. It was super, super interesting. Let's open Era Skull and Bones. Oh. Oh. Gotcha. Okay. It is a JPEG. There is no alpha information. So, to add it, we do just want to put this here. And the color should be the factor. There we go. All right. But it is changing more than I would expect. Because there's a mask. Or I'm doing it the opposite way. UV. Check it out here. If it ends up being too much house, don't worry about it. I can always go in and direct apply the logo. Need, oh, never mind. Super easy. Guess I should have made a PNG file. No. I mean, that's not you. No, you are totally fine. I have it working. I just didn't realize initially I had left it as a JPEG. Actually, I do think that Hoyomi made it a JPEG, actually. I see what's going on. Okay, there we go. Bam. Mix it there. Just want to look at the material for the clothing. Show me your decal. It's in a mask. And in that mask, looking at UV zero. No, it can't be UV zero. Okay, I think I have a few stylized PNG copies of that file if needed. Well, I appreciate that. But we're doing good. We're doing good. All that needs to happen. Is that? And then in our clothing here. Okay. The way it blends in Poyomi is a little different than it blends here. That's A-okay. Awesome. Next, we're gonna go to the body. Complete the ambient occlusion. For the body, there are two things we want. We want the sleeve, or three. Sleeve, mask, tail. Interesting. Why is it a little different? UV map 01. Blending. Let's turn the royal clothing off. This way, east. Gotcha. Okay. Let's see what's going on. It's because we need to set this UV to zero. Then there we go. All right, brought in the tattoo, sort of. It's the one I grabbed, right? Yeah. But is it the one we add to the body? Sorry, I'm back. No, you're fine. No need to apologize. Huh. This is the one we use, right? 90% sure. Has to be. Be a color mask mean. That's just for the normals. Is it though? No, it's not. We did use this one as well. G color. Which we didn't use a mask for, we just added. As a multiply? That's a global mask. Okay, that doesn't mean anything. UV1, that's right. It's channel G. All right. That's what we're doing. And we're using the right image. So why does it look like it's blending differently? It is blending differently. You can definitely see a star. In the star. Star. Maybe that color there. Swap. Oh, okay. That's what it is. That's what it is. It's the alpha is inverted. Okay. All right. There we go. Okie dokie. Next. Gold. I like gold. Yeah. Nice. Sorry, I'm back. Neighbors are chatty. How dare they? Gotta put them down. Lastly, the final touch are the normals. We want to add to the normals. Take this, and then we do a mix RGB here. We take our other normal, it's weird that it keeps opening different files. It's like, oh, nah, not that one, maybe this one, not that one though. Now, I approve of Chatty. I have my pirate flag and pride flag on my house, and they're still being nice. I'm very worried about the whole pride flag thing. That's fair. That's fair. Oh, looks. Well, I'm glad they are being good. Lex, what are you doing? Why are you yelling at me? Says it's a normal. What does this look like in Explorer? A texture 2D file. I don't want it to be a texture 2D file. I want it to be a normal file. Let me do this again. Take this. Nope. It's funny. I don't think non-LGBT folks realize how dangerous it is to do such things. One disapproving neighbor will. Yeah. No, I totally get it. Generate all outputs. There we go. Bake textures to fold. That's what I want. Bake them to a folder. Yes. Yes. To that half. All right, so now this is a texture. Whew. So then we can take this, put it here. Now we actually have image we can take. Bam. Perfect. Beautiful. And we want to give it, which I don't think we had to give it a map at all. We just had to mask it. Oh, there we go. That's why. Okay. Mask A. That's what we want. Bam. Perfect. Beautiful. And then we get to go here. Control T. How many times did we scale it? Probably like 20 times or something. Then we just need to invert it. I don't know why it's glossy though. Shouldn't be shiny. My coworkers can be clueless. I actually took a pride sticker on my car after an incident. Uh-oh. Like people can be petty.
People. Humans. Foolish. Humans.
Okay. So it is just the normal making it look so glossy. I'm very surprised by that. Maybe this invert is not doing entirely what I think it will. Can I just mix here instead? Instead of mixing like this, I can mix like that. Mix a little. Bam, then your color, the factor, and then we get another normal map. Stick that in there, and boom. That sure don't look much better. But it is interesting that now I am getting that same glossiness in both of them, which would lead me to believe that is in fact just something wrong with the blend. But I want the tail scales. Give me the tail scales. All right, so blender, mix, normal, maps.
That does the red chunk, then we're going to take the blue, and you guessed it, we're going to connect that to this one. So what that's doing is it's separating into the color channels, it's combined the reds, this here, green, the normal map.
Well, that's a little bit silly. That's a little bit much. Could be worse. The thing's done were minor. I don't live in the South. Down here in the South, we hug and kiss our homies. Celebrate. I do need the mask still. Shit. But it's a little different. Take the color, move it down here. We want an add. Yep, just have an add. Add. Meeting time. Meeting time. And then we combine XYZ. Damn it. Boom. Then we can stick that on the normal map. But we do have a normalize. Where is that? Or it's a vector map node. Vector map. Oh, why is it so tiny? Normalized. Better. Okay, now it's not glossy. No longer super glossy. Good. Which means. That's all I needed. I just needed that normalize node. Fuck. Funny. Take this. Mix RGB. Mask A, open. Drop the color into the factor. Take this, drop it in there. Should get something like that. Right here, get the tail correct. Noise. Swap them real quick. No, swapping doesn't make sense. But now, I can also hit it. Math. Normalize. I got a call. A telemarketer. You know, I don't think I'll answer that. There we go. Shit. I don't know why it's working so much better here. It's kind of bumming me out. Just want a nice tail. I don't want it to have that. It's just that simple. Interesting that it works so well right here. All right. It's still just a color here, so I'm gonna mix it again. I don't know why I need to pull it apart and put it back together for it to work properly, but it is working that way. So, I will do that. We're done. Got the tail working. We're done. Okay. Outfit's working. Tail's working. Good to go. Let's go ahead and save this. We're going to make a new file. Actually. And then we want to link. Then save this in thumbnail. Era thumbnail. Save. And we can go to object library override make. And this will allow us to play around with these, such as interesting. Of course, we can't touch edit mode, so it's just those ones that we can affect. All right, that works. Alrighty. So what I had in mind for this let me double check the thumbnail size. I always forget. We're going to have him kind of laying down. On his tail. It's deceptive from the camera how long the tail is. It's kind of funny. What? Why'd it go that way? I'm not picking it up that way. Alt R. Thank you. What's the best way to do that? Think I'd rather do the royal clothing. Is a bit more in line with the character. Ooh. Arctic, just went to check on some stuff on the bed in the bedroom. My cat just hauled ass from wherever she was hiding, like, nah, no, wait for me. She's now sitting on the floor yelling at me. She's feeling betrayed. Oh, that smirk though. Yes, we're trying to get that smirk looking good. Yeah, my cat Lux is mine and my brother's cat, and she likes him more. So it's pretty clear. But she's so distraught when he's traveling. She's just like upset all the time that he's gone. Man, doing the tail, I wish there was a simpler way of getting the tail to work properly, because it's a lot to deal with here. I think we'll just have to do it in like sections, basically. But they do still curl, is the challenge. Gotcha. If I take all of them, rotate them. That's a bend. Oh, that's not that bad. Okay. Interesting. If I just take these two and bend them. It's interesting because you do have to like rotate. I'm just gonna move this one down because it's off camera. Interesting little ways to bend. I feel like I should have gone the other way. Shouldn't have been on the camera. Or in front of the camera, should have been behind. I don't know. What do we think? Let's take a look. Make sure we've got ambient occlusion on, screen space reflections, bloom. And take the light. Make sure we have context shadows on. And I would like it to light up his face a bit. Blue. That's not bad. Duplicate that again. All right, just some nice rim lighting there. And we'll get the yellow light to be forward more. Maybe even like a below light. Like the soft gradient. I wanted to give him a chair, but I think we'll just make him stand. Thankfully, an easy enough change to make. I should have moved him with the hands. And yeah, I think I will move the tail behind him. So let's undo the tail, or at least these parts. Why is it so twisted? Welcome. There we go. I like that. Feels fitting. I like that. Want to bring it forward a little bit more so it has that. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Oh, it's tough because it moves the tail as well. Clicking. Gotta love rim lighting. Oh, absolutely. Essential. Required. BRB. Brib. Then as well, we want to go to shading, world, delete that, environment texture, drop it right there, open, world, we'll do courtyard. Then, of course, we're going to make the film transparent. Camera, film, transparent. So I wish we had some slightly softer shadows on the face. All right, I think that's pretty good. Let's go ahead and we'll add a this one a little bit of warmth on the tail. Not blowing out what we had before, but adding some color there. Looks good. Let's take the camera. Maybe give it a little bit of focal length. The other way. Let's go back to 50. Right about there. Grab the character. Slap on subdivision surface. Everything's looking pretty darn good. Let's go ahead and set up the rendering out. Arrow, thumb, render, accept, go back to layout, zero. Oh. Fuck. Oh, thank God. All right. Let's take the whole rig, select everything on frame zero. Oh, that's what it is. Okay. I thought I had lost my pose. All right, there we go. Now I can't lose it. And then 0, 0, 0. Just a little bit more tweaking. Just want more. Oh, follow Braburn, Braburn 97. Welcome. Welcome to the stream. We're doing some rendering for a VR chat avatar I made. Welcome. Yes, it's better. Just give it a little bit of shadow. Actually, if we put it on the other side. I think that's more what I'm aiming for. Yeah, much more dramatic. There we go. Look at that. All right, that's what we needed. Pop. The poop. Man, I'm so afraid I just lost my pose. That would have taken another 30 minutes to get back. But we survived. We survived. Nice. Very fun. Render. All right. Let's double check. Ah, I knew it. Changed it. Error. render, accept, save, render, animation. Feels a little off center. Select the body, go to the subdivision, make sure it's only in render mode. We're not too far away from 500. We're not too far away from 500 followers. Very exciting. His little fingers are poking out. Okay, after testing being beaten up by my new friend, I can say with 100% certainty, Pix V2 was cool as hell. It just took a few punches from your mute friend. I'm happy to hear it. I'm very happy to hear that. Dang it, the eyes move back. Turn off record. She came online and excitedly danced around me before wailing on me. Good. Well, I guess if you're ready for a ton of meetings, I found a break. Uh-oh. Red alert. Wow. Wow. Red alert. Bo-bo-bo-bo-bo. Hey, thank you for the sub, Era. You're too kind. Thank you so much. 2 months sub. 2 month streak, too? Subscribe for 2 months and on a 2 month streak. Wow, wow, wow. It's been 2 months already? Oh my God. Time flies when you're having fun. Since I subbed, yes. To think, Sam, you did Pix one for me like half a year ago, almost. I know. It's like, keep every time I look at the file, just like, Started watching Closer to 3 months ago. Oh, man, where's the time go? I don't like that. I do like it, but also I don't like it. Just don't sub to me. Then we're just exchanging money. You're right. You're right. IDK, but I want it small. Give me back my time. Unless you want my emotes. Give them to me. I want them. I want them all. I'll gift you a sub to my channel later then. Heck yeah. No worries. You do not have to gift me anything. I appreciate that, but do not feel obligated in any way. More like a medieval throne room kind of deal. Kind of lose the details there. Less cathedral, more throne. Oh, bam! Carrot Bear, attack! Give me this image. Lies to me. I think I sent you a piece depicting my throne room. You did. You did. I was just kind of mimicking that. All right. We just want to put a little bit of distance between Era and the background. So that's what we're trying to do here. Something like that. And then I think what we can do as well is we can actually make a drop shadow on this. Doesn't have to be a lot, just enough to give it a pop. Then probably do a little bit more there, but now doing that. A little bit darker in a few spots. And then over here. Feel like that's popping the background well enough. Poof. Makes it look a little bit smoky, but live with that. Let's make another folder for the text. T era. 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 Something dramatic. Royal. I like that. We'll do a stroke on everything. Boom. That might as well just make it black for now. Boom. Then add a levels just to Aaron. Make it pop a little bit. And also a color balance on top. Midtones a little bit warmer, shadows a little bit cooler. I think I may re-render the image with less bloom so it's not so blown out. Urban verdant. Verdant. Yeah. Or either is fine. No, I don't mind doing the full name. That's not a problem. Just let me type freaking Photoshop. Let me shrink. Frickin' Photoshop. Maybe add some red to the bottom as reflected light from the carpet. Not a bad idea at all. I like that. Tell me. A little bit hard for me to see that, but and we'll take this one, call it render. Ah, stop it. Freaking Photoshop just wants to yell at me for everything. Like bing, bing. I don't know if y'all can hear the the sound that it makes. Edit stroke. And actually start a little bit bigger. Let's say 12. All right, then duplicate it. And on the bottom one, blur it. Still not a little too much visual. A little bit easier to read. Hey there, Fat Nasty. Welcome. Hello, hello. How you doing? And let's change the text. I think it's a little bit hard to read the verdant. That feels a little easier to read. Duplicate that, move it down. Avatar owned by Arrow. Oh, that looks dope. I'm gonna swap it with that one. This gothic lettering looks very cool. I really like that. My God, I'm trying to click. What is going on? Why can I not select this? T, click. No. All right. And I think we'll make the text gold. Let go. Oh, I got pushed around quite a bit. That 90. So strange. So it does not work like I expect it to. All right, I should be looking at this a little bit more. But yeah. Gold! One last thing. Drop shadow. Or outer glow would be better. Multiply. Black. Alrighty then. I think that looks pretty good. For some reason, I can't switch to my My text brush doesn't want me to. Maybe like down here. Yeah. I like that. And I think we're going to leave it there. File, export, quick export PNG. Well, actually, I do want to export it here. Materials. No, just right here. Era, thumbnail. Boom, we go here, we up, grab the thumbnail, make it a sprite with the pivot at the bottom, and apply. Fun fact, I intend to legally change my name to that one. Oh, very cool. So we should just call you Era Bane. Permanent. Era's fine. Era Bane is the full of it. Gotcha. Oh, my knuckles. Ooh. All right, after I upload this, I will be exporting the Unity package and then going on launch. It always takes forever to load. Exporting, I feel like, takes longer and longer. Most importantly, we want to upload an image and get this situated properly. It's always a little bit hard to see. This, nope, not the character, just the thumbnail.
I think that looks good.
Go ahead and copy the transform position and upload. Do you have any ideas on doing the special streams yet? I'd love to see you do some quick doodles. Oh, well, thank you, Zoom. So far, I don't have quite the bandwidth to do it yet. But I was just thinking, yesterday I went in and did a life drawing, went to the life drawing world, and it was super, super fun. I really, really enjoyed it. And wait, let me paste it in the thumbnail. And I think I would try to do some sessions with everyone, kind of getting people into VR and then drawing in VR, probably while streaming as well. So that might be a good opportunity for that too. Just do little VR doodles. But I do think I need to actually like block out time for it, because otherwise it doesn't happen. All right, Era, a verification was sent your way. Oh shit. Yeah, I'm hungry. That should be everything for now. So too, we've been hanging with everyone. The tail looks absolutely wicked in the thumbnail. Perfect. I wanted that to be like a highlight. It was a little harder to manipulate the tail than I expected, but big tail, best tail, and I should get Should be good to get the VSF stuff moving soon. Perfect. I just need to add a default pose and get all the software rolling, I hope. Well, I wish you well. The VTuber stuff, I'm always surprised with how painful it can be at some point, sometimes. but everything, almost everything should already be in place. Certainly the animations are there. Everything from the VRChat avatar has been moved over. All right, so we sent that over. Last thing we're going to do is apply the overrides to the character, save everything. And now we're going to, once again, take the thumbnail, the avatar, and the scene. Is there anything else we added? Thumbnail. The prefab was updated and the scene updated. That's it. Okay. Yeah. We just want to overwrite so this is the tail updated. This is the tail. Thumbnail. Oh, that rhymes. And that should be it. But now the prefab includes the correct location to update on your account. So let's go ahead and get that ready. Drive. So I'm going to delete that one and then upload this one. Boom. All right. Perfect. Default pose. I think I can do in Unity for VSF. I think. I'm pretty sure that that's how it works. I believe. All right, everyone. That is it for our morning session. So I'm going to go ahead. I got stuff to do during lunch. Then I actually have to eat, try to get a workout in. And then I'll be back in probably about an hour and a half, at least, maybe 2 hours. But we would definitely be doing an afternoon session, we'll be working on some sci-fi soldier stuff. So look forward to that. Enjoy lunch, and thank you, Era. I'm very happy to get that thumbnail done. It's been on my mind. I just want to get your character polished. So, Zoom, Era, Arctic, Val, if you're out there, Fat Nasty Trash, Pixel. Who else came by today? I think called out everyone. Jordan, King Gypsy, thank you all for hanging out with me this morning. Oh, my dad came by too. Thanks, Dad. I hope you all have a great time in the meantime. And yes, I will have a nice break. Looking forward to hanging out with you all soon. And tomorrow's Friday, so looking forward to that. Hopefully I'll catch you later today, but if not, Friday. But yeah, see y'all soon. Bye, y'all. Bye.